So guys, in this practice, we are going to follow this document, which is already published on the OCP technology official website. I will put the link in video description. You can get it from there. This is my two machines. The white one machine is my primary machine and the green one is my physical standby. Let me show you the MRP process is running on standby or not. And you can see RFS and MRP process is already running on the standby machine. So before reinitiating, we need to do the failover.
What is the failover? Failover is nothing, just shut down the primary database and activate the standby database as a primary.
I'm just going to shut down my current primary database and my standby will take the place of primary database. After that, we will reinitiate our old primary. Before failover, you have to check the flashback should be enabled on both sides. On the primary machine, it is enabled.
Standby side, it is also enabled.
So before doing the failover, I'm just going to switch archive log. Let me perform last log switch. Perfect. It is applying archive number 10. And on the primary, my last sequence number is 10. So now I'm going to perform the failover. How? Just going to shut down my current primary. And after that, we'll check what happening. Perfect. So now my current primary is shut it down. Let's come on the standby machine and check the RFS process is stopped automatically or not. Yes, RFS is stopped here. Now we need to activate this standby machine as a primary. Cancel the MRP process. Perfect. Recovery is cancelled. Now it's time to finish the role of physical standby of this database using the following command. Standby database role is finished. Let's activate this standby database as a primary using the following command. We need to check the role of this database first. The database role has been changed from standby to primary. So now what we need to done, just take a shutdown normally, shutdown immediate, startup normally. Perfect. Now we have successfully completed the failover. Time to reinitiate my old primary database and activate it as a standby. So what I need to do, follow these steps, which is already published on the OCP technology official website. Just using the flashback, check the standby become primary SCN number here and check. This is my SCN number when my this standby machine take the place of the primary database. Now what we need to do, the start the old primary database till mount stage. Okay, let me do it. Let me clear the screen first. Start a mount. Perfect. Now we need to use the flashback database to SCN number. SCN we already get here. Okay, so let me do this command, flashback database to SCN number. This is my command. And what is my SCN number? This is my SCN number. So let me do it. Perfect. We have successfully performed this flashback. But if you getting the following error, ORA 38743, time SCN in the future of the database, then do not worry about it. It is just normal. You have to perform only these actions on your old primary database, then you will be able to perform the flashback. Okay, so let me skip these options and come on to the step number 5. Convert your old primary database as a physical standby. So just run here. Perfect. In the step 6, just bounce the database and start till mount stage. Let's check the database role. See, now it's become a physical standby database. This time to start the MRP processes. Let me check. Perfect. the MRB process is running. So this is the small tutorial on the failover and how we can reinitiate the old primary after failover step by step.